the world's first successful supergroup. An electrified, hot-headed power trio. Unforgettable influence then and now. And a furious, innovative blend of music like never before. Rock and Roll's Cream.
In a white room with black curtains.
Welcome to KVHU 95.3's Artist Spotlight. I'm your host, Allison Carpenter. Today's Artist Spotlight will feature the influential 1960s British rock supergroup, Cream. Cream originated when drummer Ginger Baker, known for his powerful beats with the Graham Bond organization, asked already well-known guitarist Eric Clapton to join his yet-to-be-named group. Clapton agreed on the condition that bassist Jack Bruce be asked as well. Baker and Bruce had played together in the Graham Bond organization, and Clapton described them as a well-oiled machine. They joined forces, and already considered to be the cream of the crop, they decided to be called Cream. In 1966, the trio debuted at the 6th annual Windsor Jazz and Blues Festival. The band's debut album, Fresh Cream, was released in 1966. Split between original works and covers of blues classics, the album includes the well-known number, I Feel Free, and what is considered to be one of the first drum solos ever is included in the song Toad. Cream visited the U.S. to play in New York with little impact, but stayed to record its second studio album, Disraeli Gears, in May of 1967.
I've been waiting so long to be where I'm going, in the sunshine of your love.
The album was released in November 1967 and reached number 5 on both the UK and US charts. Successfully blending psychedelic British rock and American blues, this was considered to be the band's defining collection of works, featuring well-known hits such as Sunshine of Your Love, Tales of Brave Ulysses, and Strange Brew. Although Disraeli Gears includes some of Cream's best work, the album was poorly represented by Cream live because the band was more partial to longer jam songs rather than shorter pop pieces. In 1967, the Fillmore in San Francisco and the Pinnacle in Los Angeles welcomed Cream as first-time headliners. The concerts proved the band's influence. Wheels of Fire was the group's third studio album released and includes many favorites like White Room, Born Under a Bad Sign, and Crossroads. This is the album that pushed Cream up with the likes of Jimi Hendrix and the Beatles as it topped the American charts in 1968. The recording of this album was enough to push the group members apart. Baker and Bruce had problems previously when they played together in the Graham Bond organization. Their relationship was dramatic, with onstage fights and attempts to sabotage each other's instruments. Although never escalating that far with Cream, the tension remained. The band broke up in May of 1968. This came as a shock to fans because it seemed as though the group was experiencing much success. Ginger Baker and Jack Bruce had exceptional trouble working closely together, and with equipment improving over the years and amplifiers producing larger, louder sounds, Baker had trouble drumming with the noise of Bruce's bass. Eric Clapton noted that most of the band's later performances consisted of members showing off.
You got that rainbow feel, but the rainbow has a beard.
Cream participated in a farewell tour with 22 shows in the U.S. Their final two concerts were performed at the Royal Albert Hall in November of 1968. The shows were sold out, but Baker stated that it was obviously not the band's best efforts. Cream was supported by a newly formed Yes, and Deep Purple opened for them in the first three shows of the farewell tour. Even with the decision to disband, Cream was persuaded to do a final album. The band's final album, titled Goodbye, included six tracks, was recorded in late 1968 and released early the next year after the breakup. Three of the songs on the album were live from the Forum in LA, and the rest of the music was recorded in the studio. George Harrison of the Beatles joined the band in the studio for Badge, in which he played rhythm guitar and is credited as L'Angelo Misterioso for contractual reasons. In 1969, Eric Clapton and Ginger Baker reunited briefly and created a group called Blind Faith, with the group's most notable song being Can't Find My Way Home. Come down off your throne and leave your body alone. In 1993, Cream was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame by ZZ Top. The members were wary of reuniting to perform, and Eric Clapton stated that their rehearsal the day before the induction was the first time they had played together in 25 years.
It's with great pleasure that we announce them bad, bad boys of that good thing, Cream.
There was talk of a reunion tour, but the band did not play together again until, by Clapton's request, they performed a series of four shows at the Royal Albert Hall in London in 2005, the venue of their farewell performances in 1968. The tickets sold out in less than an hour, and Jimmy Page, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, Steve Winwood, and Bill Wyman were among those in attendance. Despite many efforts to get back together, Cream resisted, and in a 2010 interview, Jack Bruce said that Cream was over. Bruce later died from liver disease in 2014. Cream's musical influence paved much of the way for blues rock and hard rock of the 60s and 70s, despite a brief two-year career. They were the first of their kind, blending blues, pop, and psychedelic rock. You've been listening to KVHU 95.3. My name is Allison, and that was our Artist Spotlight, a look at the legendary career of the British rock and roll group, Cream.